All right, so here's a equation where they want us to find the derivative. Now, this one, you could do it a couple ways. You could either use the product rule and the quotient rule to find the derivative of that, but that would take a long time, and you'd still have to simplify it at the end. The much easier way is to take the simplify this thing right here by multiplying these two out on the top and then distributing the x squared into each term to make it look like a regular polynomial, and then you can use the power rule. And the reason you can do it here is because you have a single factor in the denominator, or a single term, I should say, in the denominator. If this had said something like x squared plus 1, then you can't do that. You have to use the product rule and the quotient rule for something like that, as far as I can tell. So let's simplify this, and always write out remember, we're still just simplifying y right now. We're not finding dy dx. So this is going to equal, I'll leave the x squared on the bottom, let's distribute the x in with red here. So x cubed plus 2x squared plus 4x, and let's distribute the other one in, the negative 2 in, with the orange. So negative 2x squared minus 4x minus 8. So that's not too complicated, really. And let's just make sure we did all the math right. Good. And now let's simplify this out. We'll use green here, which is going to equal, so remember I still have x squared on the bottom, x cubed is going to be on the top still, this is going to cancel with that, this is going to cancel with that. We actually turn into a really nice, much simpler problem. In fact, if you had recognized at the very beginning, you might have recognized right away, oh, wait a minute, this is that one soap property. See how I have x cubed minus 8 as my answer? If you're really good, you can recognize, kind of like you can recognize if it was x minus 3 times x plus 3. For something like that, you can recognize, oh, hold on, that's just x squared minus 9. If you see this, you might recognize that pattern, oh, that's just x cubed minus 8, which would make this an even easier problem to do. But if you didn't, you could still just simplify it that way. Now we're going to distribute this x squared into it. So really what y equals is x, because x cubed divided by x squared is x, minus 8x to the negative 2. That's much easier to find the derivative for. So now let's find the derivative. Let's use purple. There's my derivative is going to be in purple. So dy dx equals 1, that's the derivative of x, plus 16x to the negative 3rd. And there's your answer.
Okay.
So you could have also written equivalently, you could have written it like this. Sometimes if it's a multiple choice test, you have to make sure that you're writing it in the way that they want it. So maybe they want it with positive exponents, but either one of those things is correct.